Because that man's got a lot of tricks up his non-existent sleeves.
As a matter of fact, he used some of those tricks just to win the Tucson City Championship. The gift of silence! Let's get it! The bell sounds and we're underway. These two sizing up each other right now. Of course, Cobblepot is going to have the torque and the leverage advantage as they get a collar and elbow tie-up. Chris Sindel, a little bit more experience as Dr. Cobblepot trying to get a top wrist lock.
Science!
Wow, taking his arm and breaking it up to 11. He's just absolutely, oh, whoa, the reversal on Dr. Cobblepot.
Chris Sindel getting a counter right here. I would imagine he's gonna try to take away the vertical base of Dr. Cobblepot as Dr. Cobblepot gets a reversal into a hammerlock.
Oh wow, that advantage receded just as fast as his hairline.
I wouldn't be making fun of his hairline if I were you. And now Chris Sindel trying to negotiate a side headlock and is successful at that. Starting up with a little bit of a scientific display. Very ironic.
Once again, science taking a beating in the ring right now. Dr. Cobblepot works his head out, takes control of the arm, and twists it around as Chris Sindel can do nothing but watch and get flung across the ring.
Getting nails up with a big arm drag, and Chris Sindel, like the wily veteran he is, as he's complaining to Paul Pritchard about pulling his hair.
You have no hair!
I'm not sure when he can pull that. But be that as it may, Chris Sindel, he didn't really pull his hair.
I know.
Chris Sindel is a wily veteran. He knows all of the tricks of the ring. He's going to do whatever he can to get a mental advantage over Dr. Cobblepot. He doesn't match it up in size and strength, but what he does match up with him is guile and experience, as we have another collar and elbow tie-up, and Chris Sindel getting slightly better this year.
I don't know. His antics just annoy me. I mean, that guy's got more wine than a California vineyard.
And now, trying to get a clean break.
Oh, no!
And lays him out with a big clothesline.
Out of nowhere!
Look at that. He's just really proud of himself. But you haven't won the match yet. You haven't won the title yet.
Oh, he's rewinding. He goes backwards. He hit him with the rewind button. And now he freezes him into the turnbuckle.
Remote control?
He couldn't. He was frozen. I mean, we've all had those days where you just wake up and...
Hold on. Chris Sindel, he's had about enough of this remote control.
Dr. Cobblepot struggling to push the buttons on his control. Will he be able to reach all? Just like a man of science using his head and solving the equation.
A remote control is being used in the ring. Can we never let Eddie Graham see this match from heaven, ever?
I don't know, man. But, oh, they both go for the controller! They both go for it, bud! What's going on?
Hey, wait a minute, hold on. Is this a title match or two guys trying to fight to watch television? Forget the damn remote control and let's have a title match.
Have you ever been in a fight with your spouse over the remote control? Trust me, it'll get entertaining if we let it play out.
I'm not going to argue with that. That is true. And Chris Sindel driving them cranium first into that top turnbuckle.
What is he complaining about now?
Well, he does have a point. He did have a weapon. And that was a big weapon right there, those big back elbows. Contact.
The rule scum definitely putting his scum all over Cobblepot as he lines him up for a big hit and takes him down. Oh, God. Rolled him over, bud.
Look at the far leg and only getting a two count.
Oh, no. Breaking his back once again.
Driving his back right into the... Right into the spinal cord. Dr. Cobblepot trying to get the crowd to will him to get back to a vertical position. But it's not gonna be easy. He gets the rebel scum as he drives the elbows right into the midsection, trying to get out of this predicament, and he just gets slammed in the canvas.
Ooh. Poor Cobblepot. The rebel scum is real. Hey, spit over here! Why did you spit over here?
You had a guy shove a bandana down your mouth when you're talking about people spitting. Now look at this. Stop.
Looking more like Spindel than Sindel right there.
A sickening display, and only going to get two count for his efforts. That was a sickening display. Just taunting these great fans here that don't deserve this. They paid to see good action here. They don't want to be disrespected. And a double
underhook. Oh, double underhooks into a beautiful slam. Chris Sindel. Oh my God, the Rebel Scum is definitely giving it to science today.
Like a baseball cover. A great, that was a major league maneuver followed up by a minor league mistake. But now it's Chris Sindel with the rear chin lock, and now referee Paul Pritchard checking the position into that arm, trying to make sure that it's not a choke. He's got him in perfect position. He's got the chin lock on. But now Dr. Cobblepot with a great counter right there just stuns Chris Sindel.
Wonderful counter right there. You can tell he's been planning that out the entire time, calculating very carefully his next move, and he flips him outside of the corner, hits his head in the process, and gives it right back to Chris Sindel.
And that next step right there, shades of the late Kurt Hennig, right on contact as he's doing whatever he can to try to retain the Tucson City title. And now what is Evans in mind here? Forget about the remotes, forget about the mathematical equations and science and all of that. What it boils down to is two men fighting for the Tucson City title in the
middle. Oh my God.
That vicious knee in the midsection.
Did you see? It wasn't the midsection. He hit him lower. You know, Chris Sindel would say that the South will rise again, but I don't think Cobblepot's South is going to be rising anytime soon.
Now look at this right here. The referee has to break it up. Chris Sindel, just as arrogant as can be, just posing over the prone neck of Dr. Cobblepot.
I'm the smarter one. Count
to 10.
Count
to
10. Count to 12. You gotta love our fans here at HIW.
Oh, we love all of our fans.
And now Chris Sindel trying to negotiate a suplex right here. Cobblepot having none of it. And Cobblepot gets a suplex on his own.
Utilizing the principles of leverage, he takes control of Chris Sindel and absolutely abolishes his thing.
Paul Pritchard not able to get there in time, or else I believe that would have been at the 3 count. Well, for the most part tonight, and I don't know if you can count Justice Supreme, but for the most part tonight, the referee, the officiating has been pretty much on point all night. You gotta get that much. Oh, and a vicious shot right there. And another one. Oh, did you see that roundhouse kick? I mean, look at the size of Chris Sindel. He had to get his foot up high for that roundhouse kick. And look at the percussion that they made all over the building.
Yeah, getting his leg up that high like Jean-Claude Van Damme. Beautiful.
But this isn't acting. This...
Oh, getting him up against the rope. He's got an Irish whip. That's underneath. They control the arm of Chris Sindel. And he returns the favor. Keep the change. Chris Sindel getting kicked to the back of his head.
But he's taking so much punishment, he can't get... He can't immediately capitalize. That was a great insecurity. The fans trying to will Dr. Cobblepot to his feet. But again, he has taken so much abuse in this match here.
Cobblepot
rolling over to the ropes. Get a hold of the ropes in time. Ralph, the count is still going. He hasn't gotten up yet.
And now both men back to their feet, but barely. Dr. Cobblepot signs him up right here. Now, and a big back elbow, but he's back to his feet. And
a roaring elbow up against him. Slams his face down!
This may be it right here. He has got the sting on Chris Sindel off the ropes right here and nails him with a big fist drop right across the cranium. Chris Sindel.